Hello all, welcome back to the session. Please think and reflect. Which chemical is used to test the presence of starch in food items? How do you identify the presence of proteins in food items? How do we test the presence of fat in food items? What is the role of water in digestion? Are roughages useful to our body? I think you all know that how to identify the starch and proteins in food items. We have seen those tests in the previous lesson. Now you will get the answers for other questions in this lesson. So our topic is fat test, roughages and balanced diet. In this lesson, the learner going to learn that conducts activity to identify the presence of fats. Classifies food items based on the components present in it. Explains the role of water in digestion. Applies knowledge of balanced diet and junk food in their life. That means which is good and which is not good to eat. They can identify. Okay. First, we will see the fat test. How to identify the fats in food item. For that, I conducted an activity with the groundnuts and the colocasia. You know colocasia? Calcicum. That chemagadda. Not calcicum. Colocasia is chemagadda. First, what we have to do? We have to take two papers. First, I am rubbing the colocasia piece on the paper. Otherwise, you can crush it and take the juice and apply the juice on the paper. That is also good to do. You can also do like that also. And crush these groundnuts into juice and apply the juice onto the paper. And make those two papers dry and after see. Based on the results after dry, you can identify whether it contains fat or not. Now, what we are doing, we are rubbing the groundnut on white paper. Now observe those two papers, which is translucent. Which paper has translucent? This one is colocasia paper, this one is groundnut rubbed paper. Groundnut rubbed paper change it to here, this area where we rubbed. That area change it to translucent. That means the food item which makes the white paper translucent, that food item contain fat in it. Okay. And in the previous lesson, I showed you some food items and what they contain. Potato contain carbohydrates. When it is tested, it is proved that when it is tested with iodine. And also the dough flour, rice flour, it is also changed to bluish black. That means it also contains starch in it. Lemon does not change its color, so it does not contain starch in it. Cooked rice. If you observe the cooked rice color is also changed to bluish black. So it also contains starch. Bengal gram dal flour dough. That is also changed to bluish black. Raw banana also changed to bluish black. That means these are all the food items which changed to bluish black contain carbohydrates in it. Some food items has fats, some food items has carbohydrate. In this experiment, you are observing the egg. When we tested it with the sulfuric acid, sorry, copper sulfate and sodium hydroxide, the color of egg yolk changed to purple color. See, the color of yolk changed to purple color. That means it contains proteins. When the food item is tested with the copper sulfate and sodium hydroxide, if that food item color changed to purple color, that food item contains proteins in it. We have seen three different types of tests: starch test, protein test, fat test. So the food items, all the food items generally contains all food components, but some components may be more while some may be less in it. Okay, for example, if you take rice flour, rice or paddy, it contains more carbohydrates when compared to proteins or vitamins, minerals. Okay, now I want to show you another interesting food component, that is roughages or dietary fibers. It is also one type of carbohydrate, but our body fails to digest this fibers or roughages. Then why should we eat this? Our body, we can't able to digest this roughages or fibers. Why should we eat? Means, to prevent constipation, we should take this fiber in high amounts. Okay, that means it gives the weight to the food and makes the free bowel movements in the intestines. So that is why we should take. And what are the sources of this roughages or fibers? You have seen that French beans and also the lady's finger, bitter gourd, ridge gourd, green peas or peas, carrot. Here you are observing another one, beans, soya beans, pieces, and different kinds of vegetables. All vegetable peels contains more quantity of roughages or fiber. Cucumber, keera, and almost all fruits contains this roughages or fiber in high amounts. The peels contains more when compared to the inside flesh of the fruits. Okay, so everyone should eat more fruits and vegetables, fresh fruits and vegetables, to get more roughages or fibers. It prevents constipation. Okay, that means it cleans our body. Waste materials are every day, the waste materials which are undigested materials are sent out of our gut or elementary canal or digestive system. How to eat fruits and vegetables? Generally, we have a habit of eating some fruits without peels. We eat banana without peel, but fruits like apples, grapes, etc. are eaten along with the peels. Most of the vegetables are also used along with peels. Sometimes we make some special dishes like chutneys, etc. with peels. Don't peel or discard outer layers of fruits or vegetables. They are rich in nutrients. Peel contains fiber which helps in digestion and also in excretion. But nowadays, farmers use many pesticides in fields. They are very dangerous for our health. So we must wash fruits and vegetables with salt water thoroughly. Then only it becomes safe to eat with the You eat them along with the peels. So, children, don't forget to eat the fruits and the vegetables with the peels. They are very good to eat. They contains a lot of nutrients and also the fiber that helps us a lot for digestion and also for other uses also. Now I am moving to another one interesting food component, that is water. Water is also one of the food component. We require water in large quantities. It is an essential component needed by our body. We should drink sufficient water, that is 2 liters to 3 per day. Do you know we get water from fruits and vegetables also? Most of the fruits and vegetables contain water. All the fruits and vegetables contain water in it. Water helps us in digestion and all other life processes occurs in our body. So eat seasonally available fruits and vegetables to get more vitamins, minerals and water. And I want to show you how water helps us in digestion or digestive system with the help of one activity. This is the activity shows the usage of water in digestive system or digestive tract. For this we require one PVC pipe, piece of duster and a bowl with water. First try to insert the duster piece in PVC pipe and allow it to move freely in the pipe, but it can't able to move in the PVC pipe freely. See, once again it is not moved forward. But if we dip it in water and do that activity again, that means allow the sponge to move in the PVC pipe. See how it moved freely. Like the same way food moves in the digestive tract or gut freely with the help of water, and all other activities like digestion and other life processes occurs with the help of water. Okay, so drink more water daily. Okay children, we have seen up to 8 rough ages, proteins, carbohydrates, fats, some other food components. Now I want to give you an activity that list the food items eaten by you yesterday. That means in the morning, breakfast time, lunch time, dinner time. What are the food items eaten by you? Make a list of it. That means write over here. Okay. Does your diet contains all the necessary components of food in it? That means we have discussed different kinds of food components like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, water, roughages, all. Those are all present in your food that you have eaten yesterday. For that, to analyze that, you have to write what are the items eaten by you in this table. Okay. After that, watch here, observe here, list out the food items and food components in this thali. You are observing the thali, and here are different food items given. Rice, you all know that rice contains carbohydrate or starch. We had conducted an experiment with the starch, with the iodine to find the starch in food item. Next, sambar has pulses in it, so it has proteins. Potato fry contains carbohydrates as well as fats. To fry that potato, so we add oil to it. Chapati has carbohydrates. Curd chutney has carbohydrates, carbs or carbohydrates, fats, water, etc. Bottle gourd curry, it contains water, minerals, vitamins, etc. Okay. So we eat different varieties of food items in a day, like biscuits, rice, different curries, fruits. Those are all contains different types of food components in it. Some food item contains more carbohydrates, some food items contain proteins, and some other contains water and mineral. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to eat all kinds of food items. Diet containing food items having more of carbohydrates and protein along with a little fat, vitamins and minerals makes a balanced diet. That balanced diet means we have to eat more amounts of carbohydrates and protein less amounts of fats, vitamins, minerals and some other food components. That is called as balanced diet. Is balanced diet costly? No. A balanced diet need not necessarily be costly. Everyone can afford it, even the poor. If a person eats dal, rice, roti, green vegetables, little oil, jaggery, all the food requirements of the body are fulfilled. That means that person is taking the balanced diet. Because dal contains proteins, rice contains carbohydrates, roti contains carbohydrates, vegetables and seasonally available fruits contains different types of vitamins, minerals, water. Jaggery also contains some vitamins and minerals. So that person took the balanced diet. Okay, so you children, you also eat different varieties of food item. Okay, and these are the dry fruits. The dry fruits also helps us keep our body healthy. Badam, or we call it as almond, pumpkin seeds, dry grapes or kismis, cashew nuts, dry fig fruit. Do you know? You know, many nutrients are lost by overcooking, reheating many times. Some people has a habit of reheating food items when they get cold. So we should avoid that. Washing the vegetables after cutting them into small pieces also loses some nutrient. So we do not wash the vegetables after cutting into small pieces. Before cutting into small pieces only, we have to wash the vegetables. So keep in mind, that is very necessary and useful to us. Do you know which food items are to be eaten moderately, adequately, plenty and sparingly? Food items like cereals, pulses, milk, etc. should be taken adequately. Cereals means like rice, paddy or rice are same. Paddy, wheat, bajra, jowar are comes under cereals. Pulses means Bengal gram, green gram, black gram. Those are all comes under pulses. Okay. Fruit, leafy vegetables and other vegetables should be used in plenty. We have to eat them in plenty amounts. That means they give us varieties of vitamins, minerals, water, roughages or fibers. Okay. Cooking oils and animal foods should be used moderately. Vanaspati, ghee, butter, cheese must be used sparingly. They require in very less amounts to us. So that is why we should eat very less these items. And the oils also, animal foods also. Okay. And we have to avoid to eat this junk food like burgers and pizzas. They give us a high calories of food that leads to obesity or some other health problems. So our digestive system gets damaged because of this junk food. So try to eat very rarely, not regularly. Okay. And finally, the concept of nutrition first came into existence before 170 years ago. Until about 170 years ago, there was a little scientific knowledge in the West about nutrition. The founder of modern science of nutrition was a Frenchman named Lavoisier, whose contribution paved new ways to nutrition research. The period of Lavoisier is 1743 to 1793. In the year 1752, James Lynch discovered scurvy disease, which could be cured or prevented by eating fresh fruits and vegetables. Later, that scurvy is caused due to the deficiency of vitamin C. In 1952, it was known that disease could be cured by eating certain kinds of food like C vitamin rich foods. Okay, like oranges, citrus, citron. That food items can be cured this scurvy disease, and also guava, C vitamin rich food items cures scurvy disease. Okay. In 19th century, it was known that the body obtains three substances, namely proteins, fats, and carbohydrates from the food. And later on, time moves on, so many vitamin deficiency and malnutritious diseases were discovered, and curative measures also shown by scientists. Okay, children, and now I am going to sum up. Now, main food components are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, roughages, and water. Carbohydrates, proteins, roughages, and water require in large quantity, whereas vitamins, minerals, and fats in less quantity. Okay, now try to write the answers to these questions. Write the procedure followed to identify the fat in food items. Why does our body require water? What is junk food? Prepare the chart showing balanced diet. Which food habits do you develop after learning this lesson? Why should we eat fiber-rich food? Okay. And I want to insist you again about junk food. Junk food gives us more calories than nutrients. So we should avoid to eat it. Okay. Thank you for watching. And I will meet you again with another topic. Until then. Bye.